Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is called as leverage ratio. So leverage ratio is basically used to see how much debt a company has used it, how much debt a company has used it. So in other words, you can say leverage ratios allows us to see how much the assets of the company are coming from the loans, are coming from the loans of the business entity. Now in this tutorial, we'll look at the top leverage ratio, their interpretations, and how to compute them. So let's get started on the same. At the very initial end, the capital structure of any company is divided into various forms. Like, you know, there will be involved, there's debt, there's equity, there's other components too. So let's say, you know, a debt is over here 32%. So the balance, keeping it as that we have nothing except equity. So our equity is going to be 68%. Now, the first thing that we are going to study is the debt equity ratio. This is the first and the foremost portion of the leverage ratios. The most common leverage, this is the most common leverage ratio. Through this ratio, we'll get an idea about the capital structure of the company. Now, the debt to the equity formula, the formula for the leverage ratio is basically the total debt divided by your total equity. This is the formula for your debt to equity ratio. Now, let's understand the interpretation part of this formula. See, the debt to equity ratio helps us to see the proportion of the debt and the equity, the proportion of the debt and the equity in the capital structure of the company. Like, for example, if a company is too dependent on, let's say, debt, then the company is too risky to invest in. On the other hand, if the company doesn't take debt at all, it may lose out the leverage portion and it is highly invested into equity. Let's take a practical example in the debt equity ratio. Let's say there's a company called Zing and it has a total equity. It has total equity, let's say, of $3 lakh and total debt standing at $60,000. So find out the debt equity leverage ratio for this company. Now, this is a very simple example. All we need to do is just to feed in the figures into the leverage ratio formula. So what we can just over here, we can just put the debt number 60,000. We'll put the equity numbers. So our answer is going to be debt divided by the equity, which is 0.2 over here. Now, this means that the debt is not quite high in the company Zing's capital structure. And that means it may have a solid cash flow or cash inflow. After looking at into the other leverage ratios in the financial statement, an investor can invest into this company. Now, this is the example that I'm showing you, a graph of PepsiCo's financial leverage. Now, here the PepsiCo's financial leverage is standing, was at 0.5, close enough to in 2009-2010, as you can see in the graph. However, PepsiCo's leverage ratio, that is a debt to equity ratio, has increased over time, over the years, and is currently standing at 3.38x. Also, you know, basically, you may consider that this is a highly leveraged company. Now, the next sort of ratio that we need to discuss is the debt capital ratio. This leverage ratio is an extension to our first one, that is the debt to equity ratio. Now, instead of doing a comparison between the debt and the equity over here, the ratio would help us to see the capital structure holistically. Now, the debt capital ratio formula is basically your it's known as the debt capital ratio formula. It's equal to your total debt. So it's basically, it's going to show you the proportion divided by your total debt plus your total equity. So that will show us that what is the level of the percentage of the debt involved in this. Now, this leverage ratio basically helps us to understand the exact proportion of the debt in the capital structure. Through this leverage ratio, we'll get to know whether a company has taken a higher risk or a lower risk. And we'll get to know that whether the company has taken a higher risk feeding its capital with more loans or not. Let's take an example on the same. Let's say there's a company called Company Tree. Capital structure consists of both equity and debt, and its equity, let's say, it's standing at $4 lakh, and its debt is standing at $1 lakh. So find out the debt capital leverage ratio of the Company Tree. So let's use the formula to find out the leverage ratio. Over here, the debt is 1 lakh. So we'll put in the formula over here, that our debt is 1 lakh and our total equity is 4 lakh. So we'll add in the denominator part the equity plus debt, so 5 lakh. So that's the proportion, which is 0.2, right? So this is how you have found out the second formula. That means the debt is just 20% of the total capital structure. That means 80% is equity. From the figure, we get that it's high equity company and low debt company. Now, this is the graph that we need to study. See, for the second thing, we know that the ratio has increased over here for the most of the oil and gas companies which are there in right in front of us. This is primarily due to the slowdown in the commodity oil prices. You can see all of them. And thereby resulting in reduces the cash flow, straining their balance sheet. Third ratio that we need to understand is the debt-asset ratio. Debt-asset ratio. Now, this ratio basically says that how much debt a company takes to source its assets would be known by the debt-asset ratio. This leverage ratio can be an eye-opener for many investors. Now, the formula for the same goes as the total debt divided by the total assets. So, put down numbers. Let's say your total debt is standing at 1 lakh, your assets is standing at $5 lakh. So your total debt to your asset ratio is going to be, let's say, 0.2 over here. The interpretation for the same goes that this leverage ratio talks about how much an asset can be sourced through the debt. In other words, if assets are more than debt, that means it's rightly leveraged. But if the assets are less than debt, that means that the firm needs to look out the utilization of the capital. That over here, the company, this means 0.2 means that the company has, you know, more assets than the loans, which is quite good signal. The next sort of ratio that we need to study is the debt to EBITDA ratio. Now, in this case, this leverage ratio is an ultimate ratio which finds out how much impact it has on the earnings of the company. You may ask why? Because here we are talking about the EBITDA. And EBITDA means your earning before interest, tax, depreciation, and amortization. And since a company needs to pay interest as the cost of debt, the ratio will have a huge impact on the company's earning. The formula for the same goes as the total debt divided by your EBITDA. Now, the interpretation for the formula goes as the reason the ratio is important because if we know how much the debt the company has employed compared to how much the company has earned before paying out its interest, we would know how debt can affect the earnings of the company. Like, for example, if the debt is more, the interest would be more. And possibly if the cost of debt is higher, as a result, the taxes would be less and vice versa the case. In the similar fashion, we can put the numbers. Let's say your debt is standing at 3 lakh and your earnings is 60,000. So your ratio will go as 3 lakh divided by 60,000. It's 5. So if this ratio scores higher, it means the debt is higher than the earnings, and if the ratio scores lower, the debt is relatively lower compared to the earnings, and it's a great thing. Now, I want you to understand, why do you need to look at the leverage ratio? See, as an investor, you need to look at everything. Leverage ratios will help you how a company has structured its capital. So many companies don't like to take loans from outside. So they believe that they should fund all their expansions of the new project through equity. But to take the advantage of the leverage, it's important to structure the capital with proportion of your debt, and it helps to reduce the cost of the capital by reducing the cost of the equity, and it's huge. Plus, it also helps in paying less. You pay less taxes, and since the taxes are calculated after paying the interest, that is the cost of debt. As an investor, you need to look at the companies and compute the above ratios that we have discussed, and you would get clarity about the company is able to take advantage of the leverage or not. If the company has taken too much debt, it's too risky to invest in the company. And at the same time, if the company doesn't have any debt, it may pay off too much in the cost of the capital and actually reduce the earning in the long run. But only the leverage ratios won't help you. You need to look at all the financial statements like CFS. You need to look at the income statements, balance sheets, shareholders' equity, and all of the ratios to get the concrete idea about how the company is doing. However, you know, the leverage ratio surely do help investors in deciding whether a company is taking advantage of the leverage or not.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.